Hi friends, today I'm going to discuss about the topic insertion sort technique. Let me explain this insertion sort technique by an example. I'm going to consider the example of cards, playing cards, okay? So I have a card sequence 2, 5, 4, 7 and 10, okay? So here, how can we sort these cards? First, I'll consider the first card is already in sorted order. So from the second cards onwards, I'll start sorting, okay? So I'll consider the second card 5 and I'll compare with the previous card 2. They are in proper order, so I don't perform any swapping operation here. So the sorted cards have 2 and 5. Next, I have considered the third card and I'll be comparing with the previous card. So as you see here, 5 is greater than 4, right? So 5 should be moved to the third place and 4 should be compared with the previous card, that is 2. 2 is lesser than 4, so 4 will come here and you will have this sorted card sequence, that is 2, 4, 5 and 7 and 10. So here what you are doing, you are just considering the first element as sorted element and from second element onwards you are doing the sorting technique. So I will consider the second element, I will compare those with the previous elements. If they are in proper order, you don't do any swapping here. If they are not proper, you swap them. So you will do this procedure till you get a sorted array. Okay. Let me consider this example. I'm taking an example of 5 elements and I'm going to consider index and key variables. Index will be pointing to the current index and key will be having the value pointed by this index value. So as I told earlier, we'll be considering the first element as sorted order. Okay. We'll be starting a sorting technique from this particular index, that is 1. So index will be pointing to this. And what will be the key holding? Key will be holding the value pointed by the index, that is current index is 1, the key will be having the value 5. Now what you have to do, you have to compare this element 5 with the previous index value. What is the previous index value here? That is index minus 1. What is index here? Index is 1, so index minus 1 value you have to compare, that is 9. 9 and 5 are compared. 9 is greater than 5, right? They are not in proper order, so here you have to perform swap. So after swapping I will be having 5, 9, 1, 4 and 3. Okay. So 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now index will be pointing to the second index. So here the key will be having the value pointed by the index 2. That is 1. Now 1 should be compared with the previous element, that is 1 will be compared with the previous index element, that is 9. 9 is greater than 1. So here what you have to do, you have to change the order, right? So 9 will be moved to the second index value. So 9 will come here. Okay. Now after changing the order of 9 to the right side, what you have to do, you have to decrement the index value. Now index is pointing to this one. Okay. Index is pointing to 1. Now what you have to do, you have to consider the previous index value and the key value. Right. Previous index is pointing to 1. So previous index, that is index minus 1, will be 0. Okay. 5 and 1 are compared. 5 is greater than 1. So now what you have to do, you have to move 5. You have to move 5 to the right side. So 5 will come here. 5 you will be moving to the right side. And once you have moved 5 and 9 to the right side, what you have to do? You have to place the key element. What are the value present in the key in the particular index? So here you will be placing 1. Okay. So in this way you will do. So next, again after this, index will be having the value, current index will be pointing to 3, the key value will be present as 4, okay, the value pointed by this index 3, okay. Now what you have to do, you have to perform, you have to do the comparisons of this 4 with the previous element. So you will be comparing 4 with the previous index value, that is 9. 9 is greater than 4. So you have to shift 9 to this third position. So 9 will come here. Okay. And next, what you have to do, now once you have shifted the 9 to the right side, that is third index position, you have to decrement the index value to 2. So index is pointing here. The previous index value is 5. So you have to compare 5 and 4, right? 5 and 4 you have to compare. As you see, 5 is greater than 4. It's not in proper order. So you are here, what you have to do, you have to shift 5 to the right side. So 5 will come here. Okay, 5, 9. So here the index is again decremented and it has been 1. So previous index value is 1 and 1 and 4 are compared. So 1 is lesser than 4, right? It is in proper order only. So 4 will come in this position. Okay. Sorry. Here it is 1. Here it is 1. 1, 4, 5, 9 and 3. Okay. Now again current index will be pointing to 4 and the key value will be 3. Okay. And 4. So current index will be pointing to this one now. So now what you have to do, we have to compare this particular 3 with the previous values, previous index values. So previous index value is nothing but 3 and the value present in 3 is 9. So you will be doing the comparison of 9 and 3. So 9 is greater than 3. So here what I will do, I will just move 9 to the right side. So here 9 will come and next I will be index will be decremented, it will be 3 and previous index value is nothing but 5. 5 and 3 will be compared, but 5 is greater than 3, right? So here 5 will be moved to this third location. 5 will be moved to this third location. Next, again index value will be decremented to 2. Previous index value is 4 because index is 2, previous index value is 4. Okay, 4 is greater than 3, right? Again, you will be moving the 4 to the right side. 4 will come here and 2 index value will be decremented to 1. So here you have to compare this key value with the previous index, that is 1. So 1 is not greater than 3, right? It is lesser than. So it is in the proper order only. So 3 will come. Now key value will be placed in this index, that is current index is 1, right? So in this way you will be having the sorted order. So 1, 3, 1, 3, 4, 5, 9. So in this way insertion sort works. So let's see this in program implementation. We have already seen how we can use insertion sort for sorting an array. The same thing you will be seeing now in program, C program. So in the C program, what all I need? I need an array to sort the elements. So here we are taking a fixed size, that is 1000, and here how many elements the user wants to give, he can give by a variable n. Okay. For C, and C variable is used for iteration of the loop. Index and value are the variables which are used to point to the current index, and value is used to point to the value pointed by the index. Okay. So here we are saying printf, we are giving a message to the user saying that enter how many number of elements you needed, and you are reading by the scanf method. Okay. Printf, and you are reading how many, what all elements you want to store in an array also at the runtime. That's why you are taking a for loop here. For C equals to 0, C less than n, C plus plus, scanf percentile d, ampersand array of C. Percentile d is because you are using an integer array, right? That's why. So as I told, we are always going to consider that first array is always first element, not array. First element is always sorted. So you have to start the sorting technique from the second element, that is nothing but first index. So that's why you are saying C equals to 1, C less than or equals to n minus 1, or else you can specify C is less than n, that's also right, and C plus plus. So here initially what you are doing, you are storing the iteration, whatever the current index in index variable, and the value pointed by this index variable in the value variable you are storing. That's why you are saying value equals to array of C. Now what you have to do, you have to check whether the index is greater than 0 and the value what you are going to check whether it is lower than the previous index. If it is lower than previous index, what you have to do, you have to move the previous index value to the right side, right? That's why you are saying here array of index equals to array of index minus 1. So once you have moved, what you have to do, you have to check that value whether it is lower than the previous elements, all the previous elements, right? That's why you are writing here index minus minus. This procedure will be repeated till index is greater than 0. Once this while has been exited, while has been stopped, then you have to say array of index equals to value. So what are the value are you comparing with the previous elements? That value needs to be placed in its correct position. Okay. So this is the logic for the insertion sort. We have already seen with an example earlier. So I'll just show you the execution part. So how many elements I need? I need 5 elements. So here I'm writing 9, 5, 4, 1, 3. These are my array elements. So I got an output as 1, 3, 4, 5, 9. So in this way, insertion sort works. Okay. One thing you have to remember, you are going to compare the insertion of a particular element with the previous element, right? I'm taking a second element and comparing with the first element. If they're not in proper order, I'm swapping it. If they're in proper order, then I'm going for the next element. And that element is compared with the previous element. In this way, insertion sort works. Thank you.